Hello, YouTube! I am Pinstar, and this is 2-Point Hospital Strategy and Tactics. Quick tip. So today I'm going to elaborate a little bit more on a more advanced trick when it comes to training your people up, and as far as the timing of training. Now, training is a worthwhile. It costs time and money, but it is worth both of them. But especially with a larger hospital, your staff can start leveling up and getting these free training slots a lot faster than you can get them trained up properly. Especially if you're being careful about how you're training your people, i.e., not getting too many of them off the floor at one time. Like, for example, let's just say down here, we've got 3 people that need to learn ward management 4. Darn useful skill. Definitely want to teach these 3 people it. Pulling 3 of our ward nurses off the floor at once? That's going to cause problems. That's going to cause the ward and the fracture ward to go nuts. They will be either completely devoid of people or be on a skeleton crew at best. But, you know, so the more sensible thing would be to just train them one at a time. But they're already right now. Why wait? There's a way around that. So what we're going to want to do here is we've not only got them, but we've also got our got one of our other people that can train other people. And actually, Nurse Clementine here has the teaching skill, so we can make them our teacher. Boom, boom, and boom. Now, what are we going to do, though? I mean, we are taking 4, now, not just 3, but now 4 of our ward nurses out of the mix. That can be problematic. But there's a solution to that. So let's go ahead and kick off the training and just keep the game paused. So here we've got one of our people. He's going off to learn ward management. Let's hire a temp. Let's go to our nurses. We've built up some people. Let's just grab somebody. You know what? We can grab this person. That's fine. Hire. Bada boom. You're filling in. Alright, you're leaving there. You're leaving there. So you know what? We'll just get a couple more just completely El Cheapo nurses. I don't care if they have any skills in ward. They're a warm body and they're capable of working in the ward. So now that our class is going off to do their thing, we've got some extra warm bodies in play to keep a watch on things. And you can do that for doctors, too. You know, if we were to start another class for some doctors here, let's just say treatment 2.
Thanks to Harrison Wolf.
Let's grab one of them here.
This is Harrison Wolf on 2-Point Radio. I almost didn't show up for work today.
So, 2 doctors
then
here.
I remembered how much you all miss me. So
we'll pause here. And again, it's important that you do this while paused so that you can see the little training cap above them so you can identify where they are, what they were working in, especially if they were live in a room. If they were taking a break or farting around somewhere, that's not as disruptive, and you might not necessarily need to get a temp for them. But if they were in the middle of working in a room, you can swap them out. It looks like we are our 2 of our trainers here are actually fine for the moment. So we don't necessarily need to temp them up. But now we've got our training classes going here, and this is going to be efficient. So all that's left now for us is to wait for these classes to finish. Okay, training course complete, ward management 4. Now, the second part of this little gambit here is to pull up your staff. Let us search specifically for nurses. Now, what we want to do is we want to locate our temps here. Now, you can do one of two things with them. One, because we specifically targeted some low-level people for warm bodies, we could just fire them. They're temps, after all. We don't necessarily need them. We don't want to necessarily train them. So who cares? We can just fire them. Or if, having finished your one class, you need to start up another class and need those temps to cover for them, then, well, that's a perfectly good way to go about it. How about, let's just say, maybe get some diagnostics too, for some of our nurses in here. So diagnostics too for some of our nurses. Bada boom, bada bing. Let's go see if we can pinpoint who we just grabbed. So we got one person right here. Actually, I think that was one of our temps. But yeah, you can train the temps if you want to train the temps. And you're heading off in there anyway, so we don't necessarily need them. So you can trim back the temps when you don't need them. You can rehire them later, or you can keep them around if you want to chain train people. But the main point is keep the temps around and have them fill in for the employees that you're training. And now you can go ahead. Now you can start training a lot more aggressively. You can do these bulk trainings where you take, you know, 3/4 of your workforce off the floor at the same time, because now you've got temps filling in. Are they going to be anywhere as good as your 5-star GP? Heck no. No, absolutely not. But what they will do is they'll prevent queues from piling up to the 9s and having your hospital grind to a standstill by being able to just keep people flowing. Yeah, you might get a couple of deaths here and there. Yeah, you might have a couple of more people bouncing around different diagnostics rooms because you have a herp-derp temp for your GP for a little bit, but it's just temporary. Once the class finishes, get those temps out of there and get the proper people back in. In fact, one of the things you can do to prevent your temps from working in jobs when they're not necessarily needed is you can hit them with the jobs here and just turn everything off for them. And the only time you'd ever turn something on is if you need them to temp in that specific thing. So yes, I know right now these two aren't allowed to work, but let's say I need to cover for our diagnostic nurse. Then we just turn on our diagnostics things and make them that temporarily. When we're done with them, we turn them back off or just fire them. Either way, it's a little bit more micromanagement, but it allows you to be more aggressive with your training rooms and also utilize a slightly higher capacity of training room. I still advocate that 3 chairs is the magic number because it's rare to need to train more than 3 people at the exact same time, just because of how things shake out. But, you know, try and experiment with yourself. But if you find yourself falling behind on training and you don't feel like building like a 1,000,001 training rooms or going for like the Space Invader training room due to the space and price that commands for quicker training, this is a much viable alternative that you can do with the Space Saver training room. So I hope you guys found this tip helpful. If you guys like this episode and you want to see more like it, go ahead and hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and leave me a comment. Good, better, and different. Your feedback's always welcome. So until next time, this has been Pinstar signing out. See ya!